let's dive in a little deeper into this whole concept of edges, but let's now look at images and derivatives of images. So I'd like to define an edge basically as a point in an image, pixel or group of pixels, where there is a rapid change in the image intensity function. So basically, again, we want to look at the image intensities at a discrete pixel value in a discrete form or in a function across the function itself and look for where there is any kind of rapid change, significant change. Again, the rapid change would be somewhere where the threshold value would come in. Small gradual change would be a few pixels, but also not just looking at how one pixel to the other, but a significant size of the neighborhood. Just to keep things simple, we're going to look at just the one slice through this image. This is a sample image that we will play with here. And if I was to just construct, of course, the slice of this intensity, I would get this. So in essence, as I traverse through an image, the intensity is high, where these gray values are, goes down to a little lower number, where it's darker, and then comes back up. So this is basically, on this slice is the intensity map. Here's what we want to do to this now data here. This is the intensity map. We want to actually just do a simple difference operation on it. That is, I want to take, for example, this value and difference it from the next one coming after it. And similarly, I want to basically each and every value, I want to difference it from the previous one. This is basically a simple first derivative by just doing simple differences. And if you look at this, and actually if you look at this kind of stuff here too, there is, of course, no changes here. And all of a sudden, when it comes here, there is a significant change. This would, of course, when you look at it in a difference form, would give you this change. Of course, when it gets here, it basically goes back to zero again. No change. Another way to look at it, this would be, for example, the slope of this line. The slope of this line is zero. All of a sudden, the slope goes from zero to a larger number, and then, of course, goes back to zero again. So when you notice here, goes to a larger number, goes back to zero. Similarly, when we come back here, it's this way, and again, the slope changes, and of this line again comes back to zero. So if you notice, this is an interesting phenomenon that we want to actually now capture. So this point here is basically an output of information that came from this region here, and this region here was captured by this point. So if you notice now, is these extrema points refer to this edge, and this extrema point refers to this edge. We'll only look for derivatives in x, and these are the two edges, but there's a rapid change as I traverse this way on the image. Of course, using this now edges, we would be able to find something that would always be similar, even if I actually took the image of this one, slightly moved around to the next part, or if this was translated in some way.